What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 1G of the Ultimate Let's Play, Strong Bass Cool Game for Attractive People. We're finally home, and we're going to begin the process of getting Homestar out of our house. Now we've run the race to the end of the race, we can go ahead and start.
Guess what, Homestar? Everything's all better again!
Prove it.
Okay, I think I need to, give him something here. Let's show him the trophy.
This will require some strategy. Hey, look
what
at
are you,
that
George W.
thing
Bush?
Over there.
A thing? Well.
Lights out.
Dump one, wake up!
Wait. Aw, crap. I just had a wonderful dream where I won the race to the end of the race.
But Homestar, it wasn't a dream, see? You really did win the race to the end of the whatchamacallit.
I did? But how?
How should I know? Maybe you were sleep running or something.
Yes, that makes perfect sense. Well, looks like my 23-part graphic novel can wait for another day.
Finally! I was starting to think I'd never get to maim another badly drawn teen girl ever again.
Well, now that Homestar's out of the way,
wow, Homestar's
let's
really
get rid of
something.
This thing.
Something a blind cat might have thrown up after eating a blind rat.
And before we go any further, let's
out of my house, but do I a little just teen girl squad here. Perky teen girl squad.
Teen girl squad. Cheerleader. So and so. What's her face? The ugly one. Okay, gals and gal-related girls, we fit to look so good. Now, listen. At the sub-JV basketball game tonight, all the cute boy pieces will be there. And maybe copy seconds for you.
Okay, so this combination should get me a perfect score. Let's see it in action.
Sports is boring. Books are a world in my brain.
I guess I, like, represent symbolism and stuff. Cliff noted!
That's not real learning!
Ding doodle ding doodle ding!
It's a text message! Maybe it's a boy! No, just me. Walking is like a fashion show for shoes! This new Brain Creek ringtone is hot!
Jugga jigga wugga, ding doodle ding doodle ding! Oh dang, was that Brain Creek? I love cheese! I mean Brain Creek!
My real dad just bought me a new car because he feels guilty about all the wrongs he done! He bought it at a government auction!
Explode! Mr. Paglio Gaglio Larry will be very pleased. Nuts. Oh, man. That's... Later on the game!
Uh-oh, girl types. Gotta look good despite my hairless legs. Nothing impresses like a chest pass.
He's on fire! Squawk!
The girl back to losing by 73 points. But I don't care because everybody's looking at me, doink.
I just need to get a picture for yearbook.
Oh, my lack of familiarity with Greek mythology! I snuck this brown candy bar past concession stand security.
Guess what, boy? Not on my watch, the ugly one. Chomp. What will our fair city do without this brave robotic duck? Penguin? No kidding me? A penguin, huh? All this time. It's over! Perfection! Those teen girls didn't know what hit, crushed, eviscerated, digested, or household appliance did them. 5,000 big points!
Alright, we got the maximum score. And a bonus Teen Girl Squad idea, which we can use if we want to try another path to see how the comic would go. And we got another rank up. Wonder how much more we have left here. Let's get Homestar out of the kitchen now. And we've had a lot of fun with the cell phone, but I think it's time to finally give it back.
Hey, Homestar! Look who found your cell phone!
What would I want with a phone? It's not like anyone will ever call me again.
Anyone? Not even Marzipan?
Homestar, it's Marzipan. I want you to know that while I'm still a little bit sore that you burned down most of my backyard, I've accepted your chocolate apology and am prepared to be your girlfriend again. Goodbye.
The candy walked? Hooray! Wait a minute. When did I give her candy?
You don't remember. You sent me over to her house a few hours ago with a big box of chocolate-covered organic packing peanuts.
Oh, yeah. That sounds like something I do. So what am I doing in your kitchen now with all this cooking stuff?
Beats the crap out of me.
Well, I'll just go then.
Yes, please. At last, the kitchen and all its four-year-old condiments are mine again.
Four-year-old condiments.
Now that I've gotten rid of
all, I'll probably not never eat lunch at
this
place.
Awesome chef's hat in my photo booth wardrobe.
Got another item for the wardrobe. I think that's the last one. I'll have to check my listings. And now we just have to get Homestar out of the basement now.
Yeah, yeah, whatever. Hey, look at that thing over there.
Never get tired of that. Okay, so now we need to give the criminal record to Homestar.
Hey, take a look at this.
What is it?
It's the one and only copy of your criminal record, stolen by Awesome Strongbad out from under the King of Town's butter-stained nose.
I don't believe it. Awesome Strongbad could never pull that off.
If you don't believe me, then believe the all-knowing wisdom of local television news.
Cats wearing clown costumes really do make a difference. Thanks for that important story, Mindy. In other news, citizens were shocked today when the King of Town's Hall of Records was brazenly burglarized by an unknown masked assailant. He took everything, everything, cleaned the place out. Without the criminal records, the King admits that he has no institutional memory of any crimes being committed. Anywhere.
Yay! I'm free to show my face in public again! And maybe the rest of me, too.
You nasty! Finally, the TV belongs to its one true master again! Hey, do you hear that? That, my hot ladies, was the sweet sound of Homestar's tuchus being surgically removed from my house. You hear that, house? It's just you and me.
So we finally got Homestar out of the house.
What the?
Now what?
For evil Jellicle fell! We're running here tonight!
I'll deny you oxygen to your lungs if you don't get out of here!
You know, earlier we just had to deal with Homestar. Now we gotta deal with everybody.
I'm on a wounded Twinkie, but I draw the line at veggie pizzas. Especially veggie pizzas with olives and extra King of Town slobber.
You know, the King of Town will eat anything.
He's even more ravenous than usual. Almost like he spent the last few hours in a deep dark hole or something. Wait a minute. If you're here, who's minding the concession stand?
Ooh, I got that covered.
I don't know if I would want the poopsmith running my store.
I'm sorry to hear that Homestar took the race trophy from you.
Oh, that's okay there, Brongstrad. You know what they say.
Records were meant to be broken into little bitty pieces.
But still, to have your one shining moment of glory so unceremoniously choke-slammed into the trash can of history by such a well-known loser like Homestar?
No, really, it's okay.
You know Homestar didn't really win the race to the end of the race.
I didn't.
No, it was me, in a totally knocked the head from Marzipan's float Homestar mask.
Oh, that's witch strong man.
Yeah, I just confess and they don't believe me. Oh well. Let's try and get some tunes here.
Strongman's gonna be seriously miffed off when he finds out they've tapped his melonade keg. Let's just see what's in the old CD spinner. Oh, it's Strongsad's copy of The Best of Britpout, the 90s years.
Now everyone's depressed. And King of Town's still eating. Let's see if we can get that banana peel.
Hey! Never mind.
Guess not right at the moment.
Sounds like Coach Z has forced another one of his demos onto the world.
Yeah, Coach G does have a few funny rap songs there.
Hey, ho, one, two, three, I got this party, man.
Was Homestar just doing a head spin right there?
Stop it, drop it, don't try it till you knock it. Coach Z shock like an electrical socket.
This is getting me nowhere.
Nowhere to run, nowhere to walk. I'm gonna draw you up a play with my locker room chalk.
Yes, Homestar is doing a head spin.
Hip hop objectifies women.
Whoa.
Okay, it's enough of that. Let's change the music again.
Let's see what else is in there. Oh, joy. It's that copy of Jane's ostentatious chamber music jam. I'd like to use this CD as a chamber pot.
Mr. Dawson!
I guess that's Strong Mad's CD. Now the two of them are dancing.
What's this? The cheat's assorted Latin rhythms?
A wide coggle-eye, everybody!
Now we got a full-on conga line going. Now the King of Town's out of the way, we can get the banana peel.
A banana peel? Sweet!
King We're gonna try and get rid of these guys in one foul swoop here.
As this.
So... what I'm going to do is I'm going to recline the Luxa Lounger and put the banana peel
the
near
Luxa
the window.
Lounger is even more comfortable in its ridiculously overextended
And then watch
mode.
The mayhem commence. Kind of got to do this quickly here.
That won't do anything interesting.
Mistimed it. Does he use it on the conga line? I don't want to put it there.
My banana peel. I hope no one slips on it. Yip. Yorp. Hey!
Woo! Whoops!
Darn!
Okay, let's try this again.
Choo-choo.
Guess I gotta wait for them to start facing this direction. Wait for it. Now.
I love the way I think.
A banana! Yeah.
That's what happens when you mess with General Flex, my pecs. That's me. I sometimes call myself General William Flex My Packs. Now maybe I can get some freaking peace of quiet around here.
Ow, my snot!
So there you have it, Mansoor Manor, the video game adaptation of how I finally beat the snot out of Homestar in the most direct and least convoluted way. Man, I'm awesome. Eat snail, strong man. So you see, people, that's why you can't, no you can't, handle my style because it's hot. So please allow 10 to 15 minutes for it to properly cool before you try and handle my style.
Okay, so we finally completed the first episode of Strong Bad's Cool Game for Attractive People. I'm going to do one more sub-episode in which we complete all the rest of the 100% requirements. And then after that, we are going to go ahead and begin episode 2, Strong Baddie the Free. So I'm going to call it quits here as we watch the credits roll. I'll see you next time for the remainder of what we have to do here. Until then, I'm T.U.G. Later, gamers.